Hello, I'm Andrew Middleton. I lead the Media Enhanced Learning Special Interest Group, MELSIG. And I just wanted to give a brief introduction about MELSIG, but before I do that, apologies, I can't be with you today. I am so disappointed, you cannot believe it. This is probably, well, it is actually the second MELSIG event in its fairly long history now that I've not been able to attend, but I'm really disappointed because for me, and I think for many people that do come to MELSIG events or events that we're associated with as today, you know, it is a real highlight in the year. We're amongst like-minded people. We have a common purpose, and MELSIG is about supporting that common purpose. So partnerships with amongst ourselves, the idea of networking, but also across other organisations and making connections is very much part of what MELSIG has always been about. We really value the opportunity to make connections and new partnerships. So it's great to be doing something with ELISIG and indeed with ALT again, and in this case, ALT Northwest. And I really have to thank Alex Spears before I do anything else. Alex has been associated with MELSIG for pretty much as long as we've been going. And Alex gets that idea of making the most of an opportunity to be together, to think, to learn, to develop new ideas. And I'm really pleased that the shape of the day is much more discursive than usual. You know, what we really need is to learn by comparing what we're doing, comparing our institutions, comparing our ideas, and very much thinking about a learner-centered approach to using media. And it's great to be with ELISIG and ALT, who share that interest in the use of technology. You know, there really is an obvious connection here, and we do make this connection. There are common members amongst us. So it looks like a great day to have a meeting of the clans. That's a bit of a nod to Alex, I think. That sort of came out in an email. But, you know, the idea of bringing people together is so much about MELSIG and this day in particular. As I say, I'm very disappointed not to be there. It's great that this is happening at Chester. Chester is where MELSIG really began the beginning of 2008. Then we were known as the Podcasting for Pedagogic Purposes Special Interest Group. There was actually a special funded project at that time that was looking at podcasting. MELSIG now doesn't do funding. We thrive off the energy and the interest of people who engage with the notion of MELSIG. That's all we do. We don't do money. So we are really grateful to the University of Chester today for hosting the event, because there are costs obviously associated with a day like today, and we are grateful to everyone here for making the effort, and their institutions too, who of course pay the train fares usually and make sure people get the time out to take part in these things. So, you know, this is only something that we do together because we share a common interest and purpose. So it tends to work really well. And MELSIG is fairly determined not to become dependent upon funding at the moment. I just wanted to give you a little sense of some of the things that MELSIG is doing at the moment, because most people are familiar with the events like today, but we actually do quite a lot. First of all, we meet each other. So whether we call our networking in between times MELSIG or not, the fact is that many of us are part of personal learning environments, so to speak. We are part of networks. We are part of a thriving network, and that is one of the things that we try to encourage and create an opportunity for. Opportunity is a really important word in the way MELSIG works. We produce books. We've just brought out the Smart Learning book. Case studies that came out of one or two events in particular, but subsequently other submissions of ideas. So the Smart Learning book that came out a month or so ago is available for free as an ebook from the MELSIG site, but you can buy it in hard copy. I like hard copies. It suits me despite my interest in media enhanced learning. So we've got the Smart Learning book, a collaborative endeavour, some really good 29 contributions of how people across the UK and indeed globally are using smart technologies like tablets, smartphones, how they're using social media for learning, how they are really thinking imaginatively and taking one or two risks to push, if you like, the smart learning environment forward in terms of some of the things that we now have access to. Certainly in the context of learner-generated media and learner-centered approaches to teaching and learning. And then we've got the Digital Voices book, which is also available for free as an ebook, and it also wobbles and makes a noise, so there's a real version too. You can buy both of those from Amazon if you're interested, and hopefully contribute to the next one. The next one is likely to be suggested by you. I can't tell you any more than that. That's how we work. While we're talking about writing though, collaborative generation of knowledge is really very much central to MELSIG, and we've just launched, following the publication of the Smart Learning book, there was a little bit of time to develop something that's been in our mind for a good while, that is the Journal of Media Enhanced Learning. And we have a call out for the first issue, which will appear on the 16th of October. And I'm going to repeat that call because I think you can contribute to it. If you're here at an event like this, I think you're likely to be able to offer something to our first issue, or at least you'll know someone who can. And so I strongly encourage you to look at the call. And the special focus for the first issue of JMEL is on the use of images. Its working title is A Picture is Worth a Thousand Words. We've got the smartphone cameras, we've had them for ages. The we, it refers to students, it refers to teachers, it refers to anyone who we connect with professionally. We see images being used much more frequently because we have access to the technology and the media and we are more comfortable about using it. We have tools like SlideShare, like Flickr. We have Creative Commons licenses. All of these things come together to encourage us to think more about enriching the learning environment, the way we communicate with each other and so forth by the inclusion of images. Currently, we're doing a lot more with the idea of infographics, for example. If you're doing anything like this, or you know anyone that is, then we're waiting for your paper, please. Now, you don't have to be a practiced academic writer, though we do accept research papers. We're looking for case studies. We're also looking for ideas papers. We're also looking for viewpoints papers. If you've got a particular thought about the use of graphics and images in terms of how they can enhance or transform learning, then there's a paper waiting to be written by you for MELSIG too. So take a look at that, but I strongly encourage you, whatever your experience, will support you in writing if that's what you you ask for. We want your ideas, we want your experience in that first issue, and I'm really excited that finally we've got JMEL off the ground. We're also looking for peer reviewers, very supportive people. So if you're interested in becoming involved in MELSIG in that way, then please do contact MELSIG. And on the day today, maybe Alex Spears is your first point of contact, or you can tweet MELSIG itself at MELSIG UK, or me, Andrew Middleton, at Andrew Mid. So that's more or less what I wanted to say. We are also developing other ideas, a webinar program with the Teaching and Learning Conversations Network. We are developing ideas for online learning and how we're going to offer that. And people like Alex, indeed, are looking at developing user guides and more in the way of content and artifacts for sharing what we know. Plenty of things that MELSIG is actually really trying to drive at the moment. You know, we can do it because we're digitally connected and, you know, it really works for us as a community. So please do take a look at what MELSIG might be able to offer you, and especially whether MELSIG is something you'd like to become more involved with. Anyway, I'm going to leave you with that. Thank you again to everyone for organising this event, and on behalf of me, thanks very much, Alex. Alex really, really pushed this one, and unfortunately I couldn't make the day, but that didn't matter, and of course it doesn't matter. I really hope that between you, you generate a lot of new ideas for yourself, but also for the community. Thank you.